I will call each case by case number and case name. Staff will come to the lectern, give us the request as presented. There will potentially be discussions or questions among the board members and staff. Once we are satisfied, we understand what's been presented, then I will ask if there are any persons here in support, or if the applicant or applicant's representative is here and would like to give us any additional information. If so, please come to the lectern, give us your name and address for the record, give us the information you'd like for us to take under advisement. Once you give us the information, there will possibly be discussions or questions again. Once we're satisfied we have heard from that, then I will ask if there are additional people in support. If not, then I will ask if there are any persons here in opposition or have questions about what is going on, what's being requested. If so, please come to the lectern, give us your name and address for the record, and give us the information you'd like for us to take under advisement. Please give us the information the first time as precisely as you can, so that we don't have rebuttals and re-rebuttals back and forth and have to try to wade through all that. Normally, we reach a decision here. However, it is in the bylaws. Should we feel like information is lacking or parties need to talk, then we do have the right to postpone action until the next regularly scheduled meeting. After saying that, if you have not signed in on the back table, please sign in so we have a record of your presence. The last announcement, case VAR 201706 for Rodney Tenery Jr. on behalf of Odessa Jeep Denton. That case will not be heard today. It has been tabled or postponed until the next regularly scheduled meeting at the request of the applicant. I'm sorry if anyone's here for that case, but we did not find out until today or whatever, yesterday, that this was not going to be heard. I apologize. We will meet here the first Tuesday in June at 2:30, and that case, unless something changes, that case should be number one on the agenda. It is my understanding there is a lot more to this case than was originally thought here. You might want to check with Carmella and the Lowndes County Zoning Administrator in case it's such that they pull the application all together and you don't waste another tree.
Okay. Mr. Chairman, can I get a motion on that?
Do you need a motion on it? Can I get a motion to postpone action on that case?
I said that.
I got a motion from Mr. Alvarado. Do I get a second?
I'll second the motion.
I have a second. All in favor, raise a hand. Unanimous. Thank you, guys, girls. Okay, the next case we're going to call, well, the first case we're going to call is VAR 201705, Lower Lowndes Incorporated, Jennifer Walker, with 6671 Bainbridge Drive, Brookbridge Drive, I'm sorry, Hay High.
This
is Carmella.
Mr. Strickland, I'm going to have to, I got to recuse myself on this one. Jennifer Walker is an associate of my firm, and she's representing the applicant in this, so I'm going to abstain from voting on this one.
All right, what we normally do is if you would have a seat out in the audience and come back to this group.
Okay.
Please let the minutes show that we have one abstention on this case.
Good afternoon. Part of the week we're in May already. But our first case before you is a variance request to provisions as it pertains to minimum lot width. So the property consists of 1.06 acres and is located at 6671 Brookbridge Drive. So the property just lies just outside the city limits of Hay Power. This property has quite a bit of history to it, which you can see in the letter, the applicant's letter of intent. But basically, we are asking, the applicant is asking for a variance to the county's minimum lot width requirement. A determination was made that the minimum lot width is where the house sits, and there's currently a house on this property. This property, along with other properties in the area, was created by the there was an original survey done back in the early 90s, but the survey was never recorded. because of several reasons. One, back then, the lots didn't meet the minimum lot size requirement. Well, this lot was created by deed. Later on, the lot, subject property and the lot just south of it was combined into one. Then it was broken back out again. When it was broken out, when it was subdivided, again, the minimum lot area requirement wasn't met. The R1 zoning requires that you have a 120-foot wide lot. And again, the lot width was determined at the where the house sits. There's been some conversation on, you know, where is the lot width? Is it at the front yard setback line, or is it where the house is constructed? We determined where the house is constructed. And where the house is constructed, the lot measures 113 feet. So they're just lacking 7 feet of meeting our requirements. The Board of Health didn't have a problem. Historically, we relied on the Board of Health because they set the numbers for lot width because they want enough room. So the drain fields, septic systems, and wells can meet it. At this point, it does meet their requirements as far as having enough room. And with that, the staff is making a recommendation of approval.
Any questions, any discussions from the board at this time? Thank you, Carmella. Is the applicant here, or anyone representing the applicant, or anyone who would like to speak on behalf of the applicant?
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, Board, my name is Jennifer Walker. I am representing the applicant Lower Lounge Incorporated. I work at Denver Miller Harrison Lingo, 701 North Patterson Street, Val Austin. And I just wanted to emphasize to the board that the problems presented here today with the lot width were not created by the current owners of the lots in question. They predated back to the mid-early 90s, and without a variance to meet the standards that the title to this piece of property is unmarketable, it can't be sold to another purchaser, and a new plat cannot be recorded depicting any of these properties. And essentially, there's a substantial hardship on the owner of this lot because he cannot convey title to the subject property. And we would respectfully request a variance granted on this property for the lot width. And if you have any questions, I'll be happy to try and answer them.
Any questions, anybody?
Is the house empty?
The house on lot 5, I do not believe that there is anyone living there.
Any other questions? Any discussion? Thank you, ma'am. Is there anyone else in support of this application? Is there anyone here in opposition to this application, or does anyone here have questions about what is being requested? Carmella, was there any contact with you or your office concerning this case that you're aware of?
No, sir. Other than when I posted the property, the tenants came out the door. I think they are in the process of moving, but no phone calls or anything like that.
Okay. Anybody have any questions, any further discussion before I call the question?
I have a question which isn't exactly related. This house got built in 2006, and we had ULDC in 2006, so why wasn't it meeting the standards then? How did it get through permitting?
Well, that's the question. What triggered the variance is they had a survey done, and the survey came to our office for review, and that's when we found the error.
So when the house building was permitted, nobody checked that it was meeting the whatever it needed to do.
During one time when the lots were combined, that was the only review of this lot, but there was never a survey submitted for this particular lot as an individual piece of property.
Okay.
Carmella, how many acres is this property?
1.06.
I see a silt right here that was owned by Folsom back in 92. I guess it wasn't recorded.
That survey.
As an exhibit B.
The survey by Folsom was when they combined lots 5 and 6. And that was reviewed when I was Carmella Carter.
Gotcha.
Any other questions, any other discussion? Get a motion on this request.
I make a motion to approve the request as presented.
I have a motion, Mr. Alvarado, to approve the request as presented.
Signing criteria D.
Do I have a second?
I have a second.
Mr. McCall, all in favor, raise your hand, please. Unanimous, good luck with it. All right, Carmella, next case. VAR 2017-07, Stacy Roundtree, 6119 Shiloh Road.
Yes, sir. This is another variance request that was found in the midst of us reviewing a survey plat. In this case, we have several buildings that do not meet, accessory buildings, I should say, that do not meet our setback standards. From the aerial, you can just barely see the buildings. The buildings in question are located along this property line, which is considered a side yard. The RC requires a setback of 20 feet, and all of the buildings do not meet that. Two of the buildings, I tried to highlight on your site plan, the buildings that express the variance, there's two that's shown here that they're either taking those away or demolishing. And the applicant is here, so you can confirm that. But the building that is highlighted in yellow, which is considered a barn, it has like an open, I don't want to say carport, but open shelter, and it's like 5.5 feet from the property line. So they need a variance of 14 and a half feet. The green building is about 10 and a half feet from the property line. So they're requesting a 9.5 feet variance. That building is a building highlighted in blue. Sets back about 10 feet from the property line, so they need a 10-foot variance to that. In our reviewing the variance, there were some different opinions among staff. But ultimately, TRC has made a recommendation of approval for the requested variances.
Yes. Did this owner build these, or did they buy the property with them already on?
I believe one of the buildings were able to find a building permit, and he's the owner at the time. The other two, I can't speak of.
Okay. And the building permit told him what the setbacks were supposed to be?
The building, yes. The zoning approval letter had the setback.
Any other questions? Any other discussion? Thank you, Carmella. Is anyone here the applicant or anyone representing the applicant? Is there anyone here in opposition or has questions about what is being requested? Was there anyone contacting your office concerning this case?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other discussions, any other questions as far as these three outbuildings that are encroaching?
There's no one here to speak for this?
No.
Carmella, in regards to the metal shed, is a variance being requested for that one, the one in the middle of this L11 line?
No, they are actually taking that building away.
Okay.
Yeah, they're trying to sell the property, in the process of selling the property. And actually, actually, the property is 14 acres now, but they're cutting out 7 acres to sell. And I'm not sure what's going on with the agreement. It's probably going to be combined with another lot. But two of the buildings, they're either tearing down or taking with them, which would be this building here and this building here, taking with them.
From the recommendation you have here of a 10-foot setback, it looks like you're recommending that they would, the open storage portion of the barn would need to come down.
Yes. And that was zoning and planning's recommendation to grant a 10-foot variance. That's one way to handle that.
The 10-foot would then accomplish all the building with the shed cover and post coming down.
Yes.
Does the applicant know that's what you recommended? Do you have any word from them as to whether they're in agreement or going to fight it? Or?
No, sir.
If we grant it as presented and they do not want to take the shed down, what options does that leave them? 1 year?
Yes, they can reapply for variance in a year.
In that year's time, does that mean that they have to take it off and then request a variance to put it back?
Yes.
I did, the reason for the question, I just want to make sure everybody knew that it was in the minutes that we had at least discussed that. Mm-hmm. I guess the next part of that question, which I think I already know the answer, but I'm going to ask it anyway, is if the board votes to grant the 10-foot and they turn around and come back to you and say, well, we want to go ahead and put in notice that we're going to apply, does that give them time, 1 year, to come back and leave it there, or they still have to take it off and leave it back?
We would advise they go get it teared down. Okay. If they need 30 days or 60 days to do it, then we can work with them to do that. But they need to tear it down.
Just to absolutely throw this out, we of course have the option, should the board decide to table it until next month, give the applicant a chance to understand what we are fixing to vote on. However, that does not mean we can't vote on it. Whatever the board's pleasure is today and whatever the board votes is what we'll take. Any other discussion? Any other questions? Can I get a motion on this request?
Mr. Chairman, I like the idea of giving applicant a chance to review what we were discussing here, and that we should table this matter until further until next month, give them an opportunity to understand what their options are.
I have a motion on the floor from Dr. Howell to postpone action on this for approximately 30 days to the next regularly scheduled meeting. Is there a second?
I'll second.
I have second from Ms. Portman. All in favor of the motion to postpone, please raise a hand and hold it. All opposed? The vote is 5-1 to postpone, please.
Civil defense? Questions coming?
Thank you, fire alarm. Okay, at this point, we have vote 5-1 to postpone. Carmella, I will assume that you will send them some kind of a notice or call them and explain what was going on and that if they want to be here the next time, otherwise, we will take action next time.
Sure will.
Okay, the next case is VAR 2017-08, Gregory R. Blaze, on behalf of Jenny P. Warren, Jr.
Yes, sir. This is a lot that's located in the Stone Creek subdivision. This is a request
to our minimum side yard setback requirements. In this case, applicant is proposing an addition at approximately about a 1,000 square foot addition to their west lot line. Stone Creek is a plan development, which is a master plan development, and whatever they put on their master plan is what, you know, one has to do. In this case, this lot was located in phase one of Stone Creek, and the setback requirements, the side yard setback requirement is 15 feet. Mr. Blaze is proposing an addition that will actually be 10 feet off. Requesting 10 feet on the property line. When the request, the issue came in, he requested 8 feet on the property line, but after speaking with him, he pushed his addition back to at least 10 feet. I believe in other phases of Stonebridge Creek, there are 2-foot setbacks established, but not in this particular phase. So the staff is supportive. Fire department felt there's plenty of room given the 10-foot setback.
What's the distance between the new construction and the house on the adjacent lot? The actual building?
The house on the adjacent lot looks to be about 20 feet off the side property line, so they're probably good 30 feet between the buildings. Okay.
Would it be about in line with the house on lot 20, or would it, is it shifted back as far as what the addition, the proposed addition is? Yeah, I'm wondering how the house on the adjoining lot aligns with the applicant's house.
It looks like they are a little closer to the road than the set of property.
Any other questions? Any other discussion? Is there anyone here in support of this application, or anyone would like to speak either as the applicant or on behalf of the applicant?
Yes. Good afternoon. Mr. Chairman of the Board, my name is Greg Blaze. On behalf of the applicant, Jim Warren. A little history on this is I'm a Stone Creek resident now, and have been since 2001 when I built my first home in Stone Creek. We are moving to this home at the end of the summer. We're doing a remodel. We bought this house a week before, a week after the application was due, or else my name would be the primary applicant. To answer your question about where the house is in relation to Mr. and Mrs. Stokes, which is our west neighbor, it is at least 30 feet, if not closer to 40 feet, because of the way that the addition is proposed to be pushed back to the rear of our house. So at that angle, it creates a pretty good distance between the two structures. I have met with Stone Creek and their homeowners association board. They have tabled my application until I came successfully through your board here. At which time, if it's successful, then we will go back in front of them and continue to discuss our case. As Carmela said, there are other areas within Stone Creek, the newer sections of Stone Creek, that enjoy a 10-foot setback, side yard setback. I am trying to get this opportunity to match those setbacks, albeit in one of the more original sections of Stone Creek. I could go on for a long time about this. Okay. I brought pictures.
What is the purpose for this addition?
The purpose of this addition is back in 1994 when the house was originally built, it did not take into account the size of a large SUV. And the garage is not suitable enough to carry the length of our SUV. So that's one reason. So the use of this addition would be to house a Suburban. And then I have additional storage. And instead of doing a one-story addition that would look odd with the two-story house adjacent to main house, it would be connected to, we're creating a pitched second level, and we were putting a gym and my wife's yoga studio on the second floor.
Any
the height of the adjacent building would not be higher than the height of the house, right?
That's correct.
Do you have any pictures?
I've got some artist renderings of the house. So we've got the side perspective of the primary house, the addition, and then the property line would be over here. I didn't show it landscaped because you may have a hard time seeing the perspective, but we are intent to grossly landscape this area to protect the value and view of our neighbor. You can see that the height is intended to be less. The view from the main road is quite shielded by evergreen vegetation that exists now with holly trees and the like. It would be a connected structure, connected off the rear of the house with a small hallway, approximately 7 feet long. We clearly are not trying to, and don't believe we are, detracting from the value of the neighbor's property in doing this. I have, in fact, talked with Mr. and Mrs. Stokes, who are on the west side of the property neighbor, and they have signed a little petition that I had drafted as long as my two adjoining backyard neighbors who would have quasi views of the property. Okay. I'd like to have that please take as part of the minutes. Thank you. Anybody want to see it?
Greg, do you have a fence on your backyard?
I do.
How high is the fence?
It's 4 feet. It's a wrought iron space fence. And it'll be maintained from the rear of the addition through the remainder of the road.
Any other questions? Any other discussions? Is there anyone here in support of this application? Is there anyone here in opposition, or anyone have questions about what is being requested? Carmelo, was there any contact to your office concerning this case?
Other than the president of the Homeowners Association, just want to inquire about the variance. But he didn't go either way. He made it more positive.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, any other questions, any other discussions before I try to call the question? Can I get a motion?
I'll make a motion. I'll make a motion that we grant a variance request as presented, citing criteria D.
A second. I have a motion on the floor to grant as presented, citing criteria D. I have a second. All in favor, please raise a hand. Unanimous, sir. Good luck with it.
Thank you all.
Hope it all works out.
Appreciate it.
Does what you need. Okay. Sir, were you just an interested bystander and an observer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just want to make sure you didn't have something to talk with us about. Okay. Other business. Approval of the minutes. I did not see anything I felt warranted any changes. Did anybody else have any changes, corrections, additions, deletions? Did I give the motion to accept the minutes as presented?
Make a motion to accept the minutes as presented.
I have a motion, Mr. McCall, to accept. Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a second, Gretchen. I have a second, Gretchen. All in favor, raise a hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
I'm abstaining since I wasn't here.
Okay, I'm sorry. Make a note. Abstention, all in one, because of not being here to participate. Any new business, any old business, anything we need to talk about?
Mr. Carlisle, come and deal with the business. As we are aware, the houses last meeting is today,
and I want the opportunity to tell him thank you for his years and years and years of service. And I would like to present this glass.
Full clap?
Yeah.
Congratulations. Thank you for your service.
And it reads, that also Niles County Zoning Board of Appeals presented to Dr. Willie Housel an appreciation for your dedication and service to the governments and citizens of Valdosta and Niles County, May 7, 2008 through May 7, 2017.
Serving with you. It's been a pleasure working with you. Mr. McCall, appreciate what you've done for us and our charitable work down here in the south of the town. It's good to meet everybody. Good to have you. We need some more legal representation up here. Things are getting kind of tough. But I did have black hair when I came down. You can see the gray coming out. Age since I've been here. I've enjoyed it. I do plan to serve in other capacities. If the city or the county would have. So I just need to take a step back and take a little break from everything. Appreciate it again. Thanks a lot. Staff, you're the best. We can't do it without you. We can't do it without you. I have to say that. And just try to stay here as long as you can. Stay in place as long as you can. So when we pick up the phone, we know who we're talking to and about what we can get some good information right off the bat. Thanks again. Appreciate you. Go ahead and do it. I'm used to it now. You just thanks a lot.
Okay, any other old business, new business, anything we need to discuss?
The sound is the AC. I've already called the AC company. I could have turned it off, but I decided not to. I don't know how long you guys be talking. I know maybe there might be a little bit too much hot air, so I wanted to get cold air.
A lot of hot.
As soon as the meeting's over, I cut it off.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we stand adjourned. Thank you for your service and attention.
Good job, man. Smooth.
Yeah. I can't wait to see it.
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Okay. Yes. Very glad to be here.
Yeah, sure.